I started to have power when I was 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 14 years, I remember God gave me tongues to kill someone.
God gave you tongues? Is it an instruction you're saying?
Yeah, God gave me tongues. God said, Nancy language was irritated and someone will die. If you want to kiss someone, if you want to kill someone, this is a language that you must speak.
So there are aspects of my life that I will never reveal, that are between myself, my family.
And we became who we are because of that past and that history. Mm. We became strong women because we know who we are.
From this and all of that, I mean, I heard the audible voice of God.
It wasn't the decision.
On the third day.
That one, yeah.
Like Christ himself.
What was that about?
Yes. I don't even
know.
I
you can't
know.
Just trust the person who was able to initiate a relationship with your husband knowingly and trust them with your life, with your kid.
A fancy restaurant in a beautiful place in South Africa, and he left you with 7,000
boots, babe. He's not circumcised.
I meant I was saying.
I already do it.
Yes.
Will it marry what you say you're doing? Which is...
The show is Engineer Your Life, and I'm Lungelo KM. It's another episode. I'm excited today because the type of guest we have is something that we've never had before on this channel. He's a prophet, and what I understand about prophecy is that it involves elevating into a spiritual realm that maybe some of us cannot understand. But the prophet Kwazi Mamane is going to explain to us in a very detailed manner, and we'll get to understand ukuthi why a man of his stature has chosen to be able to connect to God and serve the people of South Africa in the manner that he's serving them. Prophet Kwazi Mamane, good morning, good afternoon, how are you?
Good man of God, kunjani?
Ngithi afternoon, morning, ngoba if you are ngazi zobuka nini, so yeah, izoyithatha ngendlela ethatha ngayo. Good to have you here, man.
Ngiyavuya kakhulu, man of God. Thank you for inviting.
Who is Prophet Kwazi Mamane? I'm very intrigued because logo sikubona in the media versus the person that is on this chair namhlanje could be a totally different person. I know it's a difficult question, yeah. Who are you? But when ungasibeka as who?
I always say ndingokunde ukwazi ukhulela eBizana.
Yeah.
Was born and raised in Bizana. I started calling him when I was 12 years. 12 years.
Yeah.
I've been doing it until now.
How do you believe or recognize Ugutune calling at the age of 12?
I think for me it was easy because umakhulwam, she was a prophet, so ekhaya kwakunecawa. So every day besisiye ecaweni, 5 o'clock ekuseni, 3 o'clock emini sisecaweni. But for me, iqale ngokungibamba esikolweni where I started to see izinto zabanye abantwana, when I started to see izinto zotishala, when I behaved different kwabanye abantwana. Then luckily there was someone who I was going to guide, athi mntanam, don't worry, even if esikolweni ukhona izinto ozibonayo, even if you find challenges ukuyodlala nabanye abantwana, you ubona izinto ezingabonwa, you are different, we understand. So understand that uNkulunkulu une purpose yobomi bakho. Then I was like, ithini the purpose? Of course, when you are young, you will be frustrated. Why am I different? Why am I impilo ngafana nabanye abantwana? I mean, brothers, they go to school, they are fine, abanayo le headache nginayo, xa befika esikolweni akho nto bayibonayo. I'm just absorbing lali. I'm seeing things, we understand. So luckily, and I thank God for that, because uNkulunkulu sent umakhulu wami to guide me and to make sure that I identify my gift and I follow it and I respect it until now.
Why then umakhulu doesn't identify the gift via African spirituality and amadlozi? Athi kuwena, no, rather go the church route. Why do you think yena may identify a gift? Why ibona kanjalo?
Look, because she was a prophet,
okay.
And again, I always say to people, I didn't start as a prophet. I've never met any prophet then.
Okay.
Prophet.
Exposed.
I was never been exposed to prophets.
Yeah.
So in the prophet, even figure
Yeah.
But wow. kukhona umprofeti maybe you understand mm-hmm. but mna I knew ba amayeza ngiyawazi ayekho inhlobo yomthi engingayaziyo I knew ba I can mix yonke into ngesandla sami nginike umuntu imsizi I knew ba ngingathandazela umuntu izinto zenzeka but I couldn't identify myself find myself and give a name we calling yam okay you're a prophet uyinyanga uyintoto but I knew because bekukhona inyanga eyikhona elalini and they will come to me I will help them
yeah.
you know
yeah.
so into bengiyazi ba angiyinyanga anguye umthandazeli my gift is beyond that
sure.
you understand
sure.
because I and even now I found my gift but I haven't found the core of my gift mm-hmm. you understand I'm learning in the spirit
as
every day I'm finding myself in the spirit
sure.
wherever I'm promoted in the realms every day
sure.
but when I say to people I'm an African prophet
yeah.
African spiritualist I'm saying look at ngibheke ngelihlo of being an African
yeah.
because whatever that I'm dealing with whatever that I'm prophesying it whatever spirit that I'm fighting ngisilwa
sure.
as an African child
sure.
you understand
sure.
even the solutions zam ebantwini ziye emntwini omnyama you understand
yeah.
because yona ndwe exposed kuyo
sure.
I'm connected with ancestors I'm connected with spirit
would you say then a lot of spirituality so, the West has tried to remove Africa from it and that's why when uti I'm bringing back Africa into spirituality
look I believe man of God ukuba umuntu omnyama kusafuneka sifumane
sure
especially whoever that is in control of your spirituality mm-hmm. is in control of your life and thina abantu abamnyama we are not in control of our life abelungu basibambile basitshintsha basenza sabheka inkolo yethu as something that is demonic
or beneath
and
yeah.
beneath you check umuntu omnyama immediately kuthi umuntu uyinyanga you already uyambuza so ne ID yokuba kayanga esikolweni
uyangcola
uyathini uyathini and also nathi siyayimosha inkolo yethu you understand but ikho yethu isekuthini we try to find ourselves eBhayibhelini you understand and inkolo yethu was never founded kwiBhayibheli kuba sizozifumana eBhayibhelini thina singabantu bakwamoya ifu sifuna ukuzifumana kufuneke sizile umoya siconnecte nendalo siconnecte nemvelo because singabantwana bomgquba singabantwana bemvelo so I always say to people xa ngithetha nabo ngithi ena as much of it's good to read the Bible but don't want to find yourself there
sure.
because you may miss it until God reveals yourself until you find you will be able to find your God and uNkulunkulu wakho will connect through indalo will connect through spirituality so into yenza thina abantu abamnyama sisilahle spirit sethu which when I say to people I'm an African prophet umzekelo I always especially to Christian when I say I'm an African prophet then mm-hmm. one will say why do you call yourself an African prophet it sounds very demonic
mm-hmm.
when I say to people I believe kumakadosha who is my grandmother I believe as my angel one will say why can't you go straight to God why do you need someone to usher you to God and I said they in the spiritual realm you don't just enter you come by invitation
okay
there's no way that you can just wake up and go to the spirit
mm-hmm.
someone must invite you you must be ushered to enter in the spirit and I was ushered by my grandmother that's why every time when I'm given a platform like this I recognize her because I know she's my angel I know that kunezimpa zilwayo in dimensions in the spirit engekafiki kuzo kunezinto engizidefeatile by igrace yakhe engingakhangeni kwazi ukulwa nayo because yena sengilwela
born again believers bathi bona God is within us.
Yes.
uNkulunkulu uyamkhuleka nomikephi whether you're in the shower or semotweni you can speak to God. Jesus paid the price.
Yes.
So why aren't you conflating that idea when by saying to me I need an ancestor in the form of your grandmother to invite me to God?
No, look, man of God, Jesus paid the price for us to believe that yonke into esiyenzayo kukhona uNkulunkulu. Now understand that in the realm of the spirit there are angels that ascend for us and each generation God sent umuntu wakhe to deliver that generation.
Mm-hmm.
And unkulunkulu uzobonakala emntwini. And unkulunkulu is too big for us ukuba sisimfake ebhotileni sithi and this is the way kaNkulunkulu and ayikho enye indlela.
Sure.
And I always say to people, God is not a Christian.
Christianity is man-made.
Christianity is man-made.
Yeah, the religion part.
The religion part. And angifumaneki with religion.
Okay.
I'm not a religious person.
Okay.
That's why if kukhona inhlombe yezangoma, I'm there. If kukhona inhlombe, wherever emzini, I'm there. Because I'm not a person with religion. I'm a spiritual person. I believe in the spirit. I go in the realm of the spirit. I see things beyond time.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So I'm not a person omfumana ku religion and say in religion eat, then I must follow that.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So whoever, and again, nalendo yokusindiswa, it's something that maybe one day we should explain to people. Mm-hmm. But insindiswa ithini, and whoever come with it. What was their purpose for us? You understand? Because we can only defeat these things by talking about it, by letting our people understand. Find your own journey. Unkulunkulu uzokwazi ukuthola yourself, uzokwazi ukuthola ingilosi yasekhaya. Now you find abantwini but they go to church,
mm-hmm.
but they abasupport bazali babo. They go to church, they don't recognize izinto zakwabo. If uYesu wenza isiko lakwabo at age of 8 years, who are you not to do it? You understand? So now we need to explain to, because we are owing our kids to explain this thing, because whoever ungazazi ba usuka phi, man of God, akazuzazi uyaphi. That is why today you will see many churches everywhere you go.
Yeah.
You see a new church, but calamity is everywhere.
Yeah.
So yeah. That means there is a problem.
I angifuna udlule kakhulu in saying that we should unpack what insindiso is and who brought insindiso to Africa. What is your definition of what being born again is? And maybe how it has been distorted. Like, ngindlela esiyona manje, is it packaged correctly or isisephutheni elikhulu?
Hey, man of God, abekho abantu abakhohlakele njengabantu uthi bangama-born again. And I believe okokuba le nto kuthiwa yintsindiso awuyonto oyithethayo, into oyiphilayo.
Sure.
You know?
Actions.
And awukwazi ukuthi usindisiwe ungakhanga ugqitha entweni efanele ukuba uzosindiswa kuyo. You must face certain things for you to reach the insindiso ekhuluma ngayo. And we must not hear it, we must see it. You understand? So I don't believe really me as Mamane yokokuba ena many people bayiyo le nto bathi bayiyo. We understand?
Yeah.
And for me, if usayithetha awukayiphile, then ayikho ngaphakathi kuwe. And again, a lot of people, they talk about uNkulunkulu, but they have never met him.
Isn't this so real, prophet? Is it real? Is it real that when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you enter a new dimension of being perpetually forgiven? You live under a life of grace and peace. And then obviously, njengoba usho ama actions akho, then fanele sikubone ukuthi umuntu osindisiwe.
No, look, igama elithi insindiso li real emehlweni of those who believe in it. But those who don't believe in it, ababelieve ukuba umveli nqange wezisa uYesu ukuba ena thina sikholwe sibe nendlela elungileyo. Because for me, immediately uthi usindisiwe, then you are saying ukukhona izinto engafunekanga zenzeke ebomini bakho.
Okay.
We understand. Then it means now you look life different kwabanye abantu.
Yeah.
Now I always say to people, where do you usindisiwe? Whether usindiswanga, because insindiso it's just a gama, anyone can say usindisiwe. We understand. But phila impilo yobungcwele, phila impilo yokwazana noThixo necreator yakho. And iBhayibhile itsho kahle ubuThixo wakho emhlabeni ngumzali wakho. We understand.
Sure.
Ukhona izibusiso okufuneke uyifumane, kukhona iangels ofuneka uzirecognize ezasekhaya. Uqala kufuneke usindiswe ekhaya, usindise abantu basekhaya. You understand? So immediately, then there's a problem. And a lot of people, we see them outside more than a car. You understand? Can't funu kalube ngum sindisi, which is wonk umtu kai zalwa, uzalwa abe ngum sindisi. Kaya vela, bataba zalbaka, simtolum sindisi, ozo susen tupegwin, simtolum sindisi, ozo zisa izinto ezintsha. A car, we understand. So it doesn't necessarily mean you must go to church for you uze ube umsindisi.
Sure.
You understand? Uwe uba umsindisi even if you don't go to church.
Mm-hmm.
Because unkulunkulu akafinya unacaweni. He's everywhere. We understand? But the Christian people, the religious people, they've made it a point of saying to our people, if you don't go to church, you are demonic. If you don't go to church, these are things. These are things. Who said that? You understand? So I'm saying, if unkulunkulu ngowethu sonke, uzong understand mina the way ngingakhona, akhulume nami ngelanguage engiyi-understandayo. If unkulunkulu ufune ngize ngiba ngiyakholwa kuye, ngibe western nazi, then it's a problem. Then that God is not for me. You understand?
Yeah.
Unkulunkulu ufuneka understand my culture and my religion.
Sure.
You understand?
Yeah.
I understand who I am.
Yeah.
You understand? So that because you will never be used by God if you are not who you are. I promise you.
Yeah.
The person that you wake up saying, umbon, unkulunkulu right there.
Prophet, you speak so powerfully now and with so much conviction, but we know that it didn't start here.
Yeah.
So there is a part of you, you can correct me if I'm wrong,
okay.
There's a part of your life where you were operating in darkness, or was it Satanism? Which one was it? And can you just take me through that part of your life?
It's a part of my life that I really find it very difficult sometimes to talk about it.
Yeah.
Because people can misunderstand you,
okay,
sometimes when you talk about this. I started to have power when I was 12 years.
Mm-hmm.
When I was 14 years, I remember God gave me tongues to kill someone.
God gave you tongues. Is it an instruction you're saying?
Yeah, God gave me tongues. God said, Nancy language was irritated and someone will die. If you want to curse someone, if you want to kill someone, this is a language that you must speak.
So through words only?
Through words only.
No action, no words.
Without using anything.
No force, no weapon.
Nothing.
Okay.
I remember one day, and Angsam Zumkulu, Konda worked to Aksama Chalitin, and Angiama no Malumewam. Then this guy, they had an issue, no Malum, for whatever reason. Then one bet, and I was very angry. And as an approach, I began to say something that I can't say it now. Then the guy fell down, Wakuzul. And the spirit said, if you don't reverse it within 5 minutes, the man will die. Now, I made so many mistakes as a young man because of money, because of pressure.
Temptation.
Mostly because of money.
Okay.
If I had to be honest to myself. Because umuntu wasebhizana uthi look ngifuna i-position ethile khawenze someone agule xa ndiya kwi-interview nantsi 50,000 and cash, and I've never seen 50,000. You understand? So any woman will want you, you know, you meet new friends and all these friends bagwe big spaces and everything.
My decision makers.
And they come to you and say, I want this tender. This is 600,000, make someone disappear. They've recognized. Remember, and again, I couldn't be powerful in general word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
One will tell, but no, Lamchita can do it. Mm. No, Lamchita can do it, you know. So It's a part of my life that I really sometimes find it very difficult to talk about it because I made so many mistakes.
Would you say ukusebenzisa ama powers ngaleyo ndlela into oyaziyo guarantee ayo ukuthi yenzeka? 1, 2, it's because usuka uNkulunkulu ekunika ama powers, but then you use them for darkness. Not that the powers are dark.
No. There is a difference to go and get initiated into darkness and using your powers that God has given you and using it wrong.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
So now, I've never went anywhere to get power, to get anything.
Sure.
Ngikhule, ngikwazi ukukhuluma, ngikwazi ukumix izinto zenzeke. It just that because I was young, I end up using the power that God has given me, use it wrongly and in the wrong places. You understand? For money, for fame, for all these things that I was involved with. You understand? So, kukunomehluko, I always say to people, I can still do it even now if I choose to do it. It's just that. And this is a story that I wanna share with you. When I decided to get, I had a surgery at Cosmos City, I had a surgery at Deep Sloot, I had a surgery at Four Ways, I had a surgery at Midrand.
Mm-hmm.
I was from.
So you're selling herbal medication?
No. I was seeing people.
Okay.
Yeah, I had surgery and people abasebenza. Okay. Monday I will go to Deep Sloot
and
heal people. Then I had surgery 4 ways in Aziwa.
Mm-hmm.
Only important people knew about it. Yeah, you understand? Your slay queens, your big people, your tender people, people with money, you understand? Only then it dips low to just to see everyone. Yeah, but so I will have maybe I will choose and say I need 100 people abafuna amadoda nemali. Then I will help them. Then monthly they will give me 5,000. Each will give
50.
Yes.
Times 100.
50, yes.
This is the 4 ways branch.
This is the 4 way
branch. It makes sense because sent in. Limpilo yase sent in. Baya ifone abafuna ukuyimaintain. Bafuna amadoda nemali. So 150. Okay, yeah, it's a lot.
It was a small man. That man, I will do it a day. So I will have those people then and help them. Then they go out there, do their thing.
What is helping them?
Helping them is to make them to attract, to summon amadoda nemali. Will bring a picture to me.
Yeah.
And then say, I've never met this guy, but he's manet.
Muntangamaz,
but
spiritually, uzowenza loyo muntu, the lady who's coming to you with the picture, somehow that guy will find himself going to her.
I will tell her, but look, she picture, then come back tomorrow. Then I summon that person, then I check, but the minute he loses 4 ways, then I will call the lady and say, this person omfunayo uzobese 4 ways ngexesha elithile a restaurant, so go there. Once akubona, whatever ngizobe ngiyifake kuwo will attract him. Then boom, it's happened.
So you're saying you closed that chapter of your life, or is it something you're still operating?
No, I've closed. I don't do those things anymore.
Yeah.
No. I've grown, man of God. That's why I always say, you hardly even see me on social media.
Yeah.
I've grown. How I talk, how I do things. These are things that I really sometimes don't want to talk about because you ask me.
Yeah.
And I have to be honest.
Sure.
So I don't talk about these things because ingilosi idibani nobumdala.
Sure.
You know, I've seen people, kunomehluko ukuthwala nokulapha. You know, so kunomehluko ukuhamba uyothatha izinto nento iphiweyo. So I used my gift ngendlela wrong to other people. We understand. And I realized one day I had umntwana untomgayise, then ngangiphuma eGhana. Going in the work to accept Kumasi, and there's a good friend of mine with serious stuff, you know, and we lived many family in Abazad, you know. Then I came back home. That was a thing I had done. Then my daughter jumped and was on haka.
And you realize it clicked, Uguti. Someone's daughter can't do that because of me.
Look, man, she just said, Daddy, I love you.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened to me that day. I saw a face of my grandmother to my daughter. My daughter just said, Daddy, I love you. I thought about what have many things that I've done.
Yeah.
And I look at, I think then I had serious money. And I said, it's not worth it. And I said, it's not what I'm called for.
Mm-hmm.
It's not what I'm supposed to do. And I remember him from the source of my mom, because I called my grandmother Umama and I said, I believe my mother, wherever I call, I can go help you to what I'm doing. I look at the cars that I have and I said, it's not what I want to do. Because I knew that one day Lendo Ngenzayo is okwenziwa kum.
With the money, with the cars, with being able to attract any woman you want, with being respected by politicians, slay queens, people of influence, but there was still a void you felt. Uguti, I'm not operating in my purpose. And I need to come back to God and operate within God's purpose.
For me, it is... I want to be honest to you. Then it was never about God. It was about my spirit.
Okay.
You know, I knew God because at that time, but it was about me, it was about my spirit, it was about the peace that I didn't have, it was about me seeking to see more.
Yeah.
You know, one thing about power, you want to do more. Power, it's a virus, a poison. You get addicted every
drug.
Day.
It's a drug.
It's a crack.
Yeah. You chase the more another if, high, if, another
if,
high.
If it was Ududula, the most powerful one, you want again the powerful one.
Another more powerful one.
You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So when a person say to you, you can't defeat me, you can't do anything, you're like, who do you think you are? let's see in the spirit.
Yeah.
You know? Then you go wherever. You do your things, then you summon him. Then you, when you look at him, ah, man, I can shake this guy.
Mm.
You understand?
Mm.
I can shake this guy. You understand? So it's all about that. But there was a time in my life where I call it darkness because for me now it's darkness.
Yeah.
You understand? And to some people it's not darkness. Because what is darkness to me? It cannot be a darkness to you. You understand? We live a different life. But to me, it was darkness. Even though I had power to do it, I still have power to do it. I choose not to do it. There is no amount of money that will make me do it because I know what it has cost me.
Yeah.
In the spirit, mm-hmm. in my soul, in my mind. You understand? In the level where God wanted to put me. And I'm still facing consequences,
mm-hmm.
even now, mm-hmm. that people cannot see. I know there are people who will see Prophet Mamane, Epula Bandabanins, doing miracles. But I'm supposed to do more
mm-hmm.
than I'm doing now. But God said, how do I trust you with more power? I trusted you and I give you what it is hidden.
Yeah.
You misuse it.
Yeah.
You know, you use my power wrongly to attack people that you are supposed to protect. You know, when a person comes to me and say, Mamane, khawungenzela into khangikhuphele manje lo muntu emzini. I'll say to you 15,000 that I say consider it down. Lento kuthiwa kukuthumela isichito ngimenza umuntu engekho anuka itoilet uma ufika kuye ungakwazi ukuhlala, you know. So I look at sometimes social media, though I don't have time, and I'm like, if I was still doing what I used to do, Ben, I'm thinking I'm a gay billionaire. You know, but I thank God, man, yeah. Of God. I thank God. It's just Peter's in his window, I can't share it. It's and again, when I decided to stop, hey, I lost many people that I thought they were my friends.
Yeah. They were attracted to the power and the influence. And
I always tell the young ones in the spirit, you must never think they are your friends. You must never think they love you. They love what you do. The day you decide to stop, the day you find yourself, it will be. And especially to slay queens, I always say, there's the sad part of it, because I've worked with them, the cool. A retired slay queen now, I think it's seven's a spa. I've never seen a retired slay queen go to only apartment yakhe nabantwana.
What goes wrong? Do you think spiritually, the mali, because of how they acquired it, it just vanishes?
Because then, and it took seven zubuhle and what you can
sure.
do. Now, the problem with slay queen, they always think it's a career. And that's a mistake that they make. They always think it will always happen. I used to tell those ebendi bancedo, but look, use it wisely, because you may never find one who will give you tomorrow. But again, umuntu uthi mayisibheke, I'm still young, I'm still attracting guys. Then you nendlela ayitya ngayo, I spirit is yayala, because you find banalamntu kunento asisebenzisayo, we understand. Then I connect nayo spiritual, because money is a spirit, you understand. So ufumanise uba ayidibani in the spiritual realm. So indlela oyifumene ngayo, it really matters.
I want to move on to something that I've observed, where mhlambe you in a church, a church where it's born again believers, mhlambe one person deviates and athi uyaphuma esontweni. A few months later, they open their own church. A few months later, they drive a Range Rover and a Mercedes, and the church has got members. Have you ever been in a position where Abefundisi come to you and want to use African spirituality to grow their churches and become multimillionaires?
Look, man of God, these things, they do happen.
Yeah.
These things, they do happen. I dealt with many people, men of God, business people, many people. So spirit and dark spirit are real. So what you see when you look at people who have power, it's not what they were born with it.
Okay.
You can go and inquire power. You can go and seek power and get it. Depending, and whether it's raw power from God, whether it's evil power. But for me, I always say to people, go for power that is from God. But you must never. Back in the days, there was a man of God that says, I think umamomdanam waya kuyo, and he said, utatalomdana. He's an African spiritualist, and the guy invited me, ne, to his office. You know what the guy said? He said, Mamane, I need to deliver you. But then, and I said, no, that's fine. You want to deliver? And a powerful man of God. I said, you want to deliver me? It's fine. I'll come on Sunday. Yeah? Then I came on Sunday. And the guy called me, but no. We have Mamane, Uyinyanga, and the Lord said, Masim deliver because Guko Nindwa Rongo, Mtwanene. You understand? Then I asked the man of God, you want me to kneel down? He said, yes. I kneeled down. What I beg Sandra, what condom show Kyle like Sandlin? What I choose this Sandra, what condom show Kyle like Sandlin? Then I spoke with tongues, I'm better way over one another. And I wanted to expose him. Many men of God and many people who pray, though they believe in the prayer, but they've never seen God. And prayer doesn't mean you have power. I hope you understand what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You can be killed while you are praying if you don't have power. Because if belief yam, yes, my sister Mhlabeni was here, why Caesar to demonstrate power. And whoever omlandelayo must inquire power. Mm. If ubaba wekhaya, you must inquire power. Whether it's to your angels, umsama wakho makabe clean. Abantu mabanga mo indoda mawungathi mawubhekwa ebusweni. Indoda icinga ibingazenza. Funa ixa ibheka indoda ibethwe luvalo. You understand? Awunodibana nam esitratweni and uthethe noba kanjani. Ukhona abantu, I know there are people who are looking for me. Not because I've done anything.
Yeah.
Because they want to prove a point. Look, but as much of that guy is a prophet, but I'm shy. Mm. We understand. So umabe figa emzinam. Abanye baba figa babo ni tam. But I am an akumza pangnetam. Why? Because of power. Now, izulu likaNkulunkulu lingamandla, lingumlilo.
Yeah.
Lona lodwa lihlaba lagqithisela.
Yeah.
Libulala uthambo nomongo. So, abalibizayo abakali understand. Until ba understand ipower liphethe. But, you know, le vesithi ena. Ungathi kulentaba mayisuke isuke ngangayi understand until ngangibhekene nobubi and I said I don't want to see these people until ngigqitha ebantwini bephethe ibhamba bengifuna bazobuza kumi uba sifuna uMamane besho kumi ngeso sikhathi mabebheka mina abathi ena bhuti bathi mama babona umuntu owumama that is the power that we are talking about. Uba, the word of God, it's not knowledge. The problem, Tina, we move. We have people who have so much knowledge. I deal with power. Even in my church, I deal with power. Because I know power. I know what it costs for you to have power. I know what it requires for you to have power. I know what you need to do for you to have power. You don't receive anything in this world without power.
Yeah.
You must have power to command things as in Ekosbeko.
Sesondela, to the end of our conversation, but before we end, two more questions. One question, who is Prophet Mamane now? Prophet Mamane says he's left the dark era. He's gone back to his spirituality. His spirit and soul realized, Uguti, there are consequences to hurting people. And you are now a person who says, you no longer do that. You no longer participate in that. Noma ngabe umuntu angazokunika malini. What do you stand for now and how are you executing your calling?
I'm truthful to myself and to my calling. I'm following that which God has called me to do. Man of God, before I answer, there's never been a prophecy that I've engenzile yangenzeki. I'm on Voma from Monday to Friday.
Mm-hmm.
I prophesy ngokuhamba kwesilo kwenzeka.
Yeah.
I prophesy ngesilo esikhona manje wasizowena sawena. What people are talking about it, if you can go to my video a year ago, what people are talking about it, I talked about it a long time ago. But there will be a time like this.
Yeah.
There is a difference between a noise and power. But Prophet Mamane is someone that's sick to deliver people, to make people believe to themselves, to make people understand but ayikho iJerusalem ozoyibona ngaphandle kwale uyibonayo ngoku.
Yeah.
Akekho omnye uThixo ozophinda umbona ngaphandle kwalo onguwe. Make people believe ba they have power that is hidden kubo ngaphakathi. If you seek power to any spiritualist, you seek what you cannot find. What you are looking for is inside you. And akekho umuntu onepower over you. I don't care noba ngenzani. But if you are able to find yourself and find the source of your power, uklini ngilosi zakho, eyasekhaya nale ozalwe nayo, yonke into onyathela kuyo izofa. Be truthful to your dreams. Be truthful to yourself. Follow yourself. Make sure that you do cleansing. Ukhuphe yonke imimoya emibi. Whether wadibana nayo through sex, whether udibane nayo through friends, whether udibane nayo through ukunyathela indawo. Kuba ispirit sisibeka everywhere. You can get HIV. If I want you to have HIV, I summon HIV ndiyibeke emnyango kwakho. Xa uphuma your HIV. If I want you to have cancer, I summon cancer. Mo uphuma emnyango, you have cancer. If I want you to have isfosenhlizi, I summon isfosenhlizi. Mo uphuma emnyango nesfosenhlizi. You get what I'm saying? Mm. So all these things, you don't even have to drink it. I can summon it, then you have it. That's why I always say, when I talk to people, that is why, maybe let me not say this, because it's on shy sang about. Many people who say today they are spiritualist or bazizangoma, many of them, not all of them, they have HIV. Because HIV is better sabantu abadala. And when you have HIV, first thing you born abantu abangasekho. And you will believe ba you are called to be inyango or to be something. And you are not called for that. Kubonakalisa isibetho bethwe ngaso.
The show is Engineer Your Life. I'm Lungelo KM. Quite a different episode. Quite informative if you're a person who's deep into their spirituality or is seeking knowledge about spirituality. Prophet Cikizwa, Mamane, thank you so much for joining us. It's an open door policy.
About
whom we have great conversations with and whom we can be informed from and learn from.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. We'll see you in the next episode.